Okay. My name is Noel McMillan, and I'm a 7th and 8th grade math teacher at the Waverly Shell Rock Middle School. This is our second year of iPad one-to-one adoption. iPads have made things convenient for me as a teacher, and I think for students. The email capability to make your website interactive so kids can go to it and pull stuff off of it, that's nice. For them to turn in homework electronically, that's nice. I think there's the content part of it that's helped in terms of if I have kids who are deficient in some particular math topic, there are no shortage of websites that they can go to and practice and do that drill and skill. And you know, if I can use that effectively and if the kids take that serious, then it does free up time to do maybe some of the bigger, better problems in math class, where you can kind of just have two different types of math class, the math class out of the classroom that's drill skill, don't forget how to do this, and then let's come and apply it in the classroom. And then the third piece that I'm still striving to work towards is the creativity part of the iPad. How can the students create on the iPad to show me what they know? We as teachers can decide what apps we would like on the iPad. As long as they're free, there really isn't any stipulation as to whether we can have it or not. So, you know, you have to go out there and search and read and get on Twitter and do those things to stay involved and stay up on what apps are out there. But I learned this last year early on that I don't need to be the professional on the app in particular. If it's a good app and it's getting good reviews, students will figure it out. I don't have to be that person. So we have a lot of apps on the iPads that I think at one time we thought we might use, and we don't use them. But that's okay. We'll delete them. We'll add new ones. It's never going to be it's very fluid. And so if I think there's some possibility that I might use the app, then I'll put it on the iPad. So. We have to teach our students that they have to make better decisions. And that's always been since the beginning of time, make good decisions. And I think we're asking our students now as 10, 11, 12, 13 year olds to make more adult-like decisions in terms of how are you gonna use that iPad in the classroom? Are you gonna be dinking around on something else? Or are you gonna be paying attention to what the teacher's doing? And as much as I can rule over that and with a ruler and you know, they have to make that decision. And that's difficult, and I understand that kids aren't going to do that all the time, but I don't want to not use it because two kids I know aren't following along like they should be. Now, if we're not using iPads, I just have them turn them over. Turn over the iPads, you don't need it now, and then, you know, we're back to, well, even with the iPads turned over, it doesn't mean I have full engagement. You know, it's irrelevant. It doesn't matter. There's always kids who are going to be uninvolved in the class, probably. It's my goal to get them 100%. Using the iPad for assessment is still something I got a long ways to go to really fully implement that, I think. There are a lot of apps out there, and Socrative is one of those where I can do quick exit tickets and, you know, quick little quizzes, and I'm using that more and more. What I need to do, though, is use those to map out what I want to do next. Sometimes I do those little quizzes and exit tickets, and it doesn't, and I look at it and see, okay, yeah, they didn't get this, this is going well, but I don't always let that facilitate what's going to happen the next day. And that's just my own obstacle at this point to get over. I mean, it's very powerful. You get immediate feedback, whether using Google Forms or whatever program. I can know instantaneously how many kids can get this problem right or not, and really address those issues as they come up, rather than waiting to the homework's checked the next day or waiting for the quiz or test or something like that. But that's got to be a conscientious effort on my part to do that, and that's just something I'm still growing. Uh, We've had some workshops over the course of the summer where teachers have presented and what they're doing in the classroom with iPads. We have a full-time tech integrationist now, which I would highly recommend. You need somebody who is designated to get in your classroom and to meet with you and teams of teachers and talk about the use of technology. And you know what we are in my team in particular, you know, we're past the Miss Locke coming in and telling us, here's an app you can use, here's an app you can use. Now we're to the point where, okay, here's the content. How could technology help me facilitate that content? And if technology can't, then don't use the technology for the sake of technology. But you really need an expert, I think, in the field of technology and integrating that into the classroom so it's not technology for technology's sake. I mean, that's been a huge plus, I think, for us this school year. She has, you know, before school and after school and lunch meetings and to have that asset in the district has been huge to promote the use of that, of the iPad, and using it effectively. And there has to be desire in the teachers. I mean, it has to have a buy-in, and I don't know how that just has to grow. You know, I think anytime the best changes and reforms are always grassroots, and so if you can get a group of teachers together that have a similar passion with integrating technology, and you can go out there and find resources and talk and collaborate, I think that'll build momentum and start to spill over with other teachers.